Hi guys, today is full speed ahead work day. You will go with me on every meeting, everything I do. Well, maybe, I don't know. Okay, thank you. Mission number uno, leave the kids at daycare. And I'm going to try to make this process more efficient today. Abracadabra. Abracadabra. Well, that was convenient. I think I'm gonna teleport the kids to daycare every day from now on. Let's try and make our way into work, shall we? In the dark they go like stars, bright lights. In the night I see them glow.
This is the end of Unit 10.
Aquí termina la décima unidad.
This has been a Simon & Schuster audio presentation.
Wow, that is really cool. I've been studying Spanish for an entire year in my car. I listen every day for a 30 minutes episode, and then I do it, and then I repeat it on the way back home. Ahora habla español bastante bien, ¿sí? And now I know a little Spanish. Link in the description to when I was talking about why I learn different languages. On to something totally different. We are in the southern parts of Stockholm in an area called Årsta, and here you have this epic place called Hockeyverkstan. It's like the hockey workshop. The guys who are working in here, they have been selling hockey equipment for like 40 years. All of these stars from the NHL, they come here and they buy stuff and get the best service. There is nothing on this earth that these guys cannot fix. They can repair like everything. They are amazing. I'm just gonna leave my ice skates for some sharpening. I'm not sure what it's called in English, but they are very unsharp. We need to get them sharp, because next week is the premiere for the Rinkbandy season. It's like a mixture of hockey and bandy. No contact. But there are like old guys playing, and some of them are like crazy, so there could be some contact. But usually there is no contact, but it's a lot of fun, it's good exercise and...
Tja, tja. Slipning.
No.
Det går bra.
Rust.
Jag vet, tack.
Vad bra, tackar.
Ciao.
Super nice people.
Okay, so we have some serious engineering rock mechanic issues here. We have the tunnel right here, and they are at this section right here. Here is the machine. The reinforcement are going like this for 6 meters in the roof here. And when they exit this area, they will not need any more reinforcement, right? They will have passed this low section with the rock. And when this part is excavated, this will have no function. It's a temporary reinforcement, right?
Yeah, it's just for a safe excavation.
Yeah, exactly. So this has no meaning when you get to this point. And you also have more than 4 meters rock coverage.
Do you think the listeners will understand this?
Help me out, Rasmus. What do we do?
We drill and blast the tunnel.
So here is the tunnel. In here are the expected rock coverage of the tunnel. The problem is that here is the low point. You have like below 4 meters. That is no good. If you get below, even more below, this one could collapse this way into the tunnel. We do not want that. Are we too loud? I'm sorry, we're gonna be more quiet.
Okay, bye.
Let me give you some content of what we are doing here. because after that discussion, we did not make any sense at all. Basically, we have this project, which in the production stage, they are building it right now. They have some issues with low rock coverage for the tunnel. What this means basically is that you would like to have 10 meters or more with rock coverage and then soil and earth and everything to make sure that the tunnel does not collapse. Like the roof falls down, you don't want that. But here they only have like 4 meters at some points. The tunnel is like 4.5 meters wide, 5 meters high. You do not want less than 4 meters because then you need to do reinforcement before you can blast and excavate the tunnel. So we were basically discussing how to do those reinforcement of this tunnel and what to tell the entrepreneur to do when they move forward, pretty much. Let's just say that there is no simple solution to this. It's a lot of thinking, a lot of calculations, and that's why we call it badass tunnel rock mechanics engineering, because it's really complicated. Well, it's a part of the job. And with that said, I think it's time for lunch.
Specially made.
Great lunch, great view. And I forgot to mention it earlier, but the subscribers for this channel has gone through the roof. Not too long ago it was only like 100. Only like, that's a lot for me, but now there is 147 of you. Thank you for watching, I appreciate it a lot. It keeps me inspired.
Ta-da! I just gotta go and pick up my skates again.
I mean, it was kind of awkward this morning. When I left the skates and there was this thick layer of rust on them. Not very professional of me. It's the summer disposal. They got messed up.
Ja, det är de.
Ja, fina gamla. Just det.
Jo. Tack så bra i fall.
Ja, tack.
Ja.
Hej då.
Hej.
Super sharp. I can't believe how nice these people are. I get amazed every time. Super good service. So here in Sweden we have this thing called fika, and every Wednesday the company buys us sugar cookies so we get fat, right?
Yeah.
For my YouTube channel. So,
hello.
Say hello.
Hello.
Dagar gånger år och sen bara gör han en prognos.
So I am on my way home. And I'm gonna spin you there. Hold on. And I'm home. And there is crazy action going on here. So you are telling me I cannot drive in here with the car because you have paint on the asphalt?
Yes.
So where should I put the car?
Där.
English, son. I told you to speak English when I'm vlogging. So anyway, I would have to put the car down there because they don't let me destroy their paint. English, son. English. Come on.
He was only joking, Haley.
So the end of the day's vlog is slowly closing in. I'm gonna end today's vlog right here, but you're going to come with me for a while, because I'm going to work out. I'm gonna bring this little camera. So here you have the equipment. You have the GoPro right here, and then you have the EOS 80D camera. This is the rig I shoot the vlogs with right here. So you have GoPro. Canon, GoPro, Canon, GoPro, Canon, go. You get it. And this is called multi-cam editing. When you use several cameras and you just connect them together. It's quite awesome and super simple if you use Final Cut Pro X, which I use. So I'm just gonna turn the Canon off now. Right here. And we're on the GoPro. So let's go work out. I don't know how this GoPro works in low light conditions, so this might look like shit. But we are biking to the workout. And then you have the wind in the microphone. This is what you get when you use the GoPro with no external mic. Yeah, let's go. That's the end of today's vlog. See you around. You want to say something smart? Boop, 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 boop.
Get it. Get us, fatto.
Yeah. That's my neighbor. But on the way back, it was like better. If I would have been a soccer player from a league in Southern Europe, I would have been looking like this. But I'm not as weak as a soccer player. Because I used to play hockey. But it can actually dictate with the help of Siri now that they've done this update in the Apple TV interface. Did I mention? This is just before lunchtime, and they usually kill each other a lot extra before lunchtime.